Hey guys, welcome back. I'm here with Reese.
Hey guys.
Silence, sort of silence track. We're doing a deep dish apple crumble pie. Vegan. Neither of us are vegan. Reese eats primarily plant-based. I also eat primarily plant-based, but not exclusively. We enjoy cooking stuff. Every now and then, not often, not but often. Sometimes. Yeah. Especially dessert, because who doesn't love a good dessert? And I don't know, I've never actually made, I mean, I don't make anything really, but apple pie seems like a fun thing to make and fairly straightforward.
Delicious.
So.
We haven't had one in a long time.
Prep time, 20 minutes. Cook time, 40 minutes. Total time, 1 hour. As you can see, we've laid out our ingredients. There's certain things like, it says almond meal. We have almond flour. I think in this recipe, it's not gonna matter. If you're making like a cake, I think you can't change them. I think you need almond flour, you can't use almond meal. But I think almond meal probably adds to like a crumbly texture or something, but it's still essentially the same thing. So hopefully, fingers crossed, it works fine.
It doesn't work out, it's on laws.
You would. It says, what does it say?
Light brown sugar.
Have you ever heard someone? This is obviously an American website. Minimalist baker. Mm. I've never heard of light brown sugar before. But it has brown sugar, so it went with brown. Normally, I think we both prefer raw, but that's probably used in teas and coffees and stuff, so maybe it's different. So hopefully that's right. Hopefully it says unbleached all purpose flour. Oh, but that's definitely bleached. But that is bleached.
No, it says unbleached.
Well, don't judge a book by its colour.
Unbleached.
Even the cover does say that it's unbleached. Then how do they get it so white? And all-purpose flour, I think, is the same as plain flour. I don't know. Okay.
I just realised I turned it around. I had it on both sides.
Shall we begin? Preheat oven to 204 degrees Celsius. That is there in the background, as you can see. For the crust, mix. Now, I'm kind of worried about this because we've made quiches before in a pastry and it's liquid that builds up at the bottom and then it goes all soggy on the inside and the pastry doesn't cook. So I think you're meant to cook this pastry separately, but I'm gonna get it myself. So mix salt in flour and cut butter into flour with a fork or pastry cutter until well blended. Add enough water until the dough scrapes away from the bowl, usually about 3 to 5 tablespoons. So pie crust. Let's get some bowls. 1 heaping cup of unbleached all-purpose flour. Heaping cup.
It was just a generous cup.
One generous cup. I'm not getting a new shirt. 1 heaping cup. Oh, that's steady hands. Remember in the Boohoo video? You said we would be doing a cooking video and you said 6 months.
Hmm.
1 week later, he came through.
1 week. In like 2 weeks, I think.
Huge difference.
Yeah, it's double the time. It's a big difference. 1/2 teaspoon of salt.
Oh, I have Himalayan salt. I feel like it's not going to be fine enough, but last time I didn't use salt in my dish, everyone ripped me new. 1/2 teaspoon of salt. God, they're chunky.
Yeah, this is going to work.
We shall see. Kind of looks a little bit like craters in there, but it's alright.
It'll work out.
Yeah. Mix salt in flour and cut butter into flour with a pork or pastry cutter until well blended. How much butter do we need? 6 tablespoons. Are you going to use a proper tablespoon? You should.
Yeah.
6 tablespoons.
I'm just going to
get all the toast crumbs in there as well. Added texture.
Crummy.
That's 1 generous. I'm using Nutrilex, best vegan butter in the world.
Soft and cloudy.
Soft and cloudy.
Apparently.
That's what it says.
Reduce fat.
Oh.
That's what it says.
Soft and cloudy. That's a weird marketing claim.
It just shows.
Next. Oh, I didn't keep track. Small.
No, we need 6, but how many
6
is that?
That's 4 lumps. Now, 4 lumps.
Come on. Get it all right.
Evan's like, come on guys, I'm ready. Fill me up. Reese and I tried to film this yesterday and my laptop wouldn't work.
We had technical difficulties.
And I was done. I did my makeup and everything, set up everything. I was keen to film. And I was in a bad mood.
Slowly her mood declined as the night went on, and we gave up in the end.
We did give up, and it was the correct thing to do. But no, but then I was in a bad mood. Reese trying to build up my mood was staring at me as it was close to my face and said, "You've got a long black hair in your nose." Like trying to blind the mood.
Funny just talking
now about. Imagine you're bad, but you got a long blade.
It was a distraction. Thanks.
Distraction of the best kind.
Yeah, what are we doing with it?
Mix salt in flour and cut butter into flour with a fork or pastry cutter until well blended.
Is that just pressing
in? Show the viewers
at home. I'm assuming that's what cutting is, because I'm not a baker, so I can't tell.
To well blended, add enough water until the dough scrapes away.
Add some more. Or add some water. Add a tablespoon. Put a tablespoon over the top.
Tablespoon.
Over the top.
Ah!
That was a bad idea. It's a lot easier with some water, just so you know.
How many tips?
That was two, basically. So you need to do another
one. Was that just one?
No, it was just some people
do. Wasn't it just going out the edge?
Some people do. We're on two, so this is three. Just, that's about it. See how
it goes.
Three to six, doesn't it?
Enough until the water scrapes away. It's going enough, I'm sorry.
Might need another one.
Might need another angle, like a top level angle to really get in there. Good job. Yes. Ah, it's crumbling out of the bottom.
One little problem.
Add enough water until the dough scrapes
over. Dough there. As you can see.
Here's one I prepared earlier. What else are we doing? Oh, there's leftover.
You can still see the bits of salt.
Oh, gross. This is what we have for the... Oh, this is spiky. For the... Oh, that's pretty shallow. Ew, last time we used this was
the quiche.
It says
10 inches, isn't it?
Oh. Yeah, but I think theirs is a little bit deeper than ours. But you may do with what you have. I just hope it's not going to leak out of the bottom. Remove from bowl, mold together with hands on a well-floured surface. Form into a 1-inch thick disc and then roll it out into an even circle. Tell you what, I don't know if we have ever used this.
Yeah, we've done a video with it before.
The last time we used it, we made a video. Yeah, what was that? 10 years ago.
We made those...
vegan cinnamon rolls.
Cinnamon rolls, that's it.
I think that was also the minimalist bake.
Is that enough? Or?
Yeah, should I just dust it out a bit more?
Use your hands first.
Put your hands in there.
You do flour on your hands and then make it into a ball. And then you roll it into a 1-inch thick.
I like a little border of the apples. What am I doing?
Remove from bowl, mold together with hands on a well-floured surface. Be a hero.
Every single meal we eat contains two or three meals. This feels like human skin, I don't like it. Human flesh. Like fat. Boom. Imagine if Reese started licking it clean off the bowl.
Yeah, just imagine it.
Reese goes hide into the corner. Alright.
About that bit.
Every last drop, peeps.
So once you've got your 1-inch thick disc, roll it into an even circle, adding more flour if it's sticky.
Move the apples away. A clearer view of what's going on. Do you want to lift that over this and see if it's at the right size yet? Yeah, I think that's right.
If
I lift this up, it's going to just crumble. Just
mark it.
How the hell on earth am I going to be able to pick this up? It's like a solid. There's no way on this planet Earth.
Use a rolling pin to roll it up. Rolling pin to roll it up and lay it gently over the 10 inch.
Can you put some dusty dust in there, please? Oh, not right now.
What do you mean?
Wait, before you do that, let me just gather up some. Is this what it means?
No, it's food.
Because I'm doing it anyway. It says roll it up.
Yeah, so you use the rolling pin. May I jump in and show you? To roll it over the pin.
Oh.
And then you roll it back over the.
You're a chef in a past life, all these things I don't know about you.
That's it. Roll it up.
Oh, I'm getting flour everywhere. You're really pushing it. Nah, this is not about to do that.
No, you're flour in there.
See how it's. Unless We should have done it at the end of the thing so I could slide it down.
Yeah, but what's ice not sticking together? It means the pastry's not going to be as good as it could be.
So we can't get this off the counter. It's too wet. Great stuff. Actually, I don't know what we're going to do. Stuck here forever. We're just going to start peeling the apple while we try and take a new approach to this failure so far. It's not a failure yet.
Do you ever have peeling competitions with your brother and sister?
No.
We do.
What's a peeling competition?
Put it on the next app.
We have to do like one long...
Yeah, as long as you can get it.
That's cool.
Maybe get the longest line.
It's a good way of getting the kids to get in so excited about peeling apples. Yeah, this is better. I can actually roll it without it getting too... So let's try this rolling pin thing again. Yeah, that's better.
More flour worked?
Yep. If you're making this at home and it sucks, you need more flour. Take it from us. All right, I need your help, quick. Almost there.
Yeah.
Ah. Nah, I need to start again.
Try it.
So did I. Alright, let's try this the third time. Probably ruined the donut because it's 3 minutes later so much, but used about 3 kilos of plain flour. This is what happens when you're not a pro. There's probably so many people watching this thinking you're doing it wrong. And to that I say, I'm not surprised. I'm really getting sick of this pie crust.
Is that aircon on?
Holy Jesus, come on, give a girl a break. I'm not cut out for this life.
You mean try?
No. I'm not feeling good about this, peeps. I'm just gonna fill in some gaps the old fashioned way, gluing it all together.
Shuffle the prep time out to about 60 minutes. With two people.
Yeah, well, we're not all professional bakers out here. We're all doing our best. They haven't folded over the edges. Well, la dee da.
The haircuts these days.
Ray's just said, that's the haircuts these days. It's true. Have you ever one of those? Yeah, you've had one of those before. A makeshift pie. There were some other ones on there that were like, they didn't have the crust. But when I think of an apple pie, I think of an apple pie encased in crust. In pastry, I mean. And this one's not going to have it over the top, but it's still going to have it. But I think it's riskier because more can go wrong.
More crumble on top than a crust, though.
Yeah. But I like the ones with it. I mean, I also think of, yeah, a dry crust. I mean, skin. Anyway, look. This is as good as it's going to get.
Cool. Next step.
What is that? What do you do with that? Remove from bowl, mold together with blah, blah, blah. Use a rolling pin to lay it over jelly. It should extend to the top of the pan, but you don't have to crimp the edges or anything. Like going for rustic. Well, I crimped the edges and added it back on, so whatever. Refrigerate until you're ready to add the apples. Add them to the same bowl that you made with dough. Do we have an apple corer?
Yeah. That one that's cut
ahead. Oh, yeah, yeah. Let's pour some apps. What does the thing say? Who's read the next instruction?
For the filling, next, prep the apples.
Oh.
Add them to the same bowl as you made the dough in and toss with sugar, cinnamon, and flour.
Oh, yeah. Ah, that's how you do it, hey? It's a lot of apples.
Juicy. I know. Face.
Who invented the apple quora? What a legend.
You can now find these on the home pizza.
That one's a sloppy one.
What?
All right, we've got the epaulets.
To cut them together.
Slithers with that, this is how it goes.
Oh, you just want them in like that?
I mean, is that how they're meant to go in there? Let's see their picture. No, they've got them in slithers, so outline that. I don't like that. If, don't assume that everyone that makes your dishes knows how to cook.
Yeah, slices.
I rely.
These aren't slices.
Oh. Okay, I take my aggression. So what, I just stole this with a knife from you?
Cut
him in half then? Drink him in half? Just half once? He's going rogue, he's doing his own thing. Alright. For filling. Three quarters of a scant sugar. What does that mean? If you googled scant, it means little. Like a little amount of... Then little... A little... Why... If you say a third of a cup, is a third of a cup or not? Maybe it has a different meaning that we don't understand.
Yeah.
Third of a cup of sugar. And what sugar? Because she specified what sugar in the crumble topping, but not in the filling. Oh, I need them at my back. Getting all sugars. Bundaberg. 3/4 of a cup, please, sir. Oh, who designed that? It's all gonna be okay.
No.
Just tossed half the sugar onto the floor, but that's okay. 1 tsp of cinnamon. Oh, it's already one.
Sugar cool. Mix around.
Yeah, we don't use one of those. We don't use like four.
Oh, so
no. Sorry, this is how it's looking so far. I'm just showing the audience. I get a little bit harder for you. Pretty good so far. I was thinking, wow, 1 tsp of sugar, I mean, of cinnamon is not going to be enough. But I think it'll be, that's already got like a still half left. All right, open the new butts. Let's go. Oh, it's all melty. It's nice. Adding the butter. I need to mix this in though. I wonder what the flour does, creates a, like a crust. Look, I am not cut out for a cooking life. It's just...
Don't worry about the little bits.
What?
Don't worry about the little bits.
Waste not, want not.
Right, what's next?
That's what it looks like, peeps.
So we're not actually supposed to add the butter in then. So you just toss with the sugar, cinnamon and flour, add to the crust, then put the butter on top. Didn't read ahead.
Well, look, it's going to be nice and buttery throughout.
So it's scrolled anyway. Into little dots or strips. Next, put that in the bowl, in the crust.
We might have some leftover apples. Just saying. Like to make a mess. I mean, Reese doesn't, but yeah, all little gaps. Good idea.
It'll be alright.
That bit in the corner needs more.
Yeah, this will be delicious.
Looks pretty damn good.
A little bit more.
Stabs up. How many do you want?
We put our mixture onto it too,
actually. Oh, yeah, just drain it. Like, hold the things in. So, we're draining some of the buttery, sugary,
deliciousness.
Delicious mixture.
How good it looks.
Keep it at bay. And if you were on top. That's how many we have left. That's probably 1 apple, would you reckon?
It's probably, no, it'd be fine because you need a thicker, a deeper, thicker pan. Whatever you want to call it.
Wait, that needs to go in the middle.
And put some more in. The topping just sits on top, so.
But then it'll just crumble off when you add it.
Hmm?
I think that's enough. I think we're good with that. Reese is eating them raw, straight out of the box. Pan, bowl, all of the above. Reese doesn't even cook it, just takes it to the couch.
Mm.
Alright, what's next?
Sweet, huh?
That looks pretty dang good. Watch me drop it. Alright. Add the tumble, crumble topping ingredient.
The tumble.
And mix with fingers or pastry cutter.
What are the topping ingredients?
I thought this isn't going to sit very well on this, but that's okay.
You need to cut the pecan up.
The pecans. Calms. All right, what do we got? We've got a cup of rolled oats. My pleasure. What do they taste like? I imagine they taste like walnuts.
Yeah.
That is a walnut.
Similar.
Oh, let's bring out the machete. Wait, where did the almond oil come in?
Yeah.
Here we go. 1 cup of rolled oats. 1/2 cup of almond meal. Yeah, that's how you pronounce it. We went through a phase of getting like lots of different flours and cooking ingredients. We made, well, what did we make that time? Oh, like
the cakes and stuff. Cinnamon scrolls and the biscuits.
That phase passed. 1/2 cup of almond meal. 1/2 cup of roughly chopped pecans.
So 1/2 cup, and just do the whole lot.
Let's measure it, let's be sure. It's gonna be right on perfect. Perfect. Look at that. Reese is a winner.
What are you doing?
Can someone please tell me the difference between pecans or pecans if you're American? Pecans. But then Americans say oregano instead of oregano. So, you know what I'm talking about. The difference between those and walnuts. Are you just eating the batter? Mm-hmm. Alright.
How much butter?
That's how it's looking. Let's all add the dry ingredients first. 1/3 cup packed of light brown sugar. I will need your assistance here, please. You always hold the... Thanks. Why is this like... It's not like...
Hold it.
I don't fold it too much because then it's going to open in. It might open more. And that's more than 1/3 cup, but...
Wait. So we're now what?
We're mixing this?
Mixing with fingers.
I just wash my hands.
Pastry cutter until crumbly. Pour it over the pie, spreading it evenly to coat.
I'm getting in there.
And push it together, it's gonna be crumbly.
So much butter in there to be crumbly.
Mm. Just crumbly.
Is it tablespoons or teaspoons of butter? Because that is. Yeah.
4 tablespoons of cold butter. Salt, 1/3 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of chopped pecans, 1/2 cup of almond meal. We put almond meal in.
Yeah.
Rolled oats.
Maybe that's why it's different, because almond meal is finer.
Maybe.
But this is not going to crumble.
So that's just absorbing it.
Hey memes, what did you just do? I'm just going to crumble this. It's not really totally... I think it's probably fine though. It still does crumble. It'll melt. That's what I tell myself.
It's gone.
I don't know how that looks. All right.
You spread it out. It's just a topping, isn't it? So.
Yeah. And it'll lose its bulkiness once the butter melts. It'll be instantly.
Hmm.
I just want to make sure it doesn't go over the sides.
In your bed. In your bed.
Mia's roaming around doing her little...
In your bed.
Annual inspection. Annual.
She's like looking as she's going.
Yeah, all right, like a drunken, disorderly person at a bar. Yeah, I'm going, shut up, I'm going.
And sits upstairs.
And you're just mapping out the floor, haven't sniffed there, gotta sniff there later, make sure. Mm. Longitude, latitude, gotta get that spot.
That's good.
Hey, that was pretty damn good. I'm sure the viewers at home. Careful, though, don't tumble over.
It's not coming.
Nutrition per... Oh, don't look at how many calories per slice.
Yes.
Whoa.
We're not eating it to be healthy, we're eating it because we enjoy it.
You put it on a dish first?
Yeah, you're fine. Oof, lost the hour.
What?
Focus.
Yeah.
How long for? Just half of it. No, it's been up, pause.
35 to 45 minutes, or until the pie is warm and bubble at the top, which is just what you said.
So we'll see you then. We'll check it out once it's cooked.
We're off to clean this mess. Bye! We have returned.
It's good.
With a masterpiece.
It's nice and brown. Crumble looks good on top. Pastry looks good. Is it hard?
Sure is.
It looks good.
Where's the sniff test?
Smells delicious. I can see it.
Oh yeah! You had some hiccups along the way. If only you could smell our house right now. We've got garlic bread cooking.
Yeah.
We've got
gnocchi.
Yeah, gnocchi pasta. Paste. We've got apple cinnamon crumble goodiness. Oh, I had no taste test yet. Come back later again.
We'll do it again after dinner. Yeah.
No way I'm eating this before.
Should we, any tips or anything they need? That we did, made mistakes?
Use flour in the pastry stuff. Don't be stingy with the flour. Yeah, that's about it, really. Ooh.
It's pretty straightforward, really. Mm. Now it's salivating. Mm. Sausage roll.
Is that? Not quite the taste we're going for, but hopefully it's right. Alright, we're back in a sec.
Pastry sausage roll. Anyway.
I'll have to eat our garlic bread and pasta. I'll come back in a few hours. It'll be dark by then, but.
See you soon.
Bye. Alright, we're back. Oh, wait.
Back.
We're back.
Now take it out.
Oh, we're already doing it, so.
Put your hand through the bottom. Voila!
It's been a few hours, as you can see. I changed out of our clothes. Why did my face look so red? This is not flattering light, but I've got professional lights right in front, but I'm just too lazy to turn them on. So,
odd colored.
I look like I've been sitting in the sun for 3 years. Nice and shiny though. Anyway, cheers. Yeah, it's been a while. I haven't felt like dessert. We had pasta for dinner, so it's like he has some pasta and has some apple pie.
Just eating the pastry is quite dry. So.
Oh, is it? I'm thirsty.
I mean, we're gonna need, we're gonna need ice cream for sure.
Need to load up on some H2O. I'm gonna have a slither.
How are you cutting it with a big knife?
My shaving.
He goes nothing.
It really should have ice cream with it. Let's start here.
Right.
We're gonna eat this all ourselves.
So we're starting here. Yeah, when it comes to the bottom, this is bad.
It's not even, but he's pushing it off the edge. Give the job to me, have you?
Yeah, okay, but.
Wait, hold it, just hold it. Ooh. What size would you like, sir?
Probably how much?
Oh, I'm so full from sculling water.
Soaring.
Yeah, chains out. You underneath the thing. Just forever trying to pull it. You're trying to pull it. Oh! Look, don't slide it off. Pretty close. Oh yeah, baby. Where's my phone? Get a snapshot. If you drop it on my computer, you're dead.
Looks good. Ooh, smells delicious. No, it's on the knife. It's on the knife.
It's not gonna be the same. Don't slip my
almost lost the plate.
Almost lost my life.
Your life. We realise we're like saying, oh, it's going to go through. It's got the thing underneath.
Well, speaking of which, the bottom is perfectly cooked. So, we decided to turn the lights on much better.
Woo!
I look translucent. It's
like we're going for a walk and the headlights like...
Anyway. Looks like a pizza from this angle.
It does, doesn't it?
It's going to slide off. I just know what this is. Stop focusing on Reese's face. You guys can't see this, but the camera always focuses on Reese's face and never my face.
Okay.
Hello, I exist. I'm trying to take it from his face. Yes! On me. It's like I have no soul or something. It doesn't see. Anyway. It looks like quiche.
Yeah.
I haven't tried it yet. I'm just spent all this time holding it. My fingers are sore. Excuse me. We already tried it, so.
Just a little bit. The whole thing has
the bottom pieces off. Pretty damn good. Definitely needs ice cream though.
Yeah. It's really nice though.
I'm so not in the mood for this now. I just sculled so much water. And as I have said 1,000 times, said pasta, so there's no space in my stomach for this food. But I'll tell you what, it's great.
It's delicious.
This is restaurant quality.
Did really well.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm just so To be perfectly honest, could have done without the pecans. What do you think? I'm gonna
boil it over. How many steam?
I don't know. Don't check. I think it actually is so like that real. In the camera. I think it's 100% it's saturating it.
Yeah. You want to watch it or are we saying goodbye?
Just end it like that.
No, so said are we saying goodbye?
No. I'm not a walnuts pecan person.
Anyway, thanks for tuning in, guys. Good luck if you make it yourself. Stick with some ice cream. Keep the pecans.
Get rid of the pecans.
A bit more sugar if you like to.
Priest love and prosperity. Too. Priest love and prosperity. Remember?
Peace. Love.
Wait.
Peace. Love.
Oh yeah, peace. I don't know. I think peace actually.
Waiting for you.
Love.
Peace, love, and prosperity.
Where'd you learn that from? Not
I did. I just made it up, I guess.
Just inspired.
Anyway.
Are you gonna finish mine?
Bye guys.
Thanks for watching. I thought that this is actually you're on a fire. My face is like shy. I wish you could see because it doesn't look as bad on their end, so it won't see it, but you're like
cooking.
Just whistling just then. Dun 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 dun. Boom boom. Alright, bye.
Bye.
Use that watching Survivor.